Molarity is just another word for concentration. The formula for molarity is equal to the moles of your solute divided by the liters of your solution. Now, molarity can be used as a conversion factor because it has two different units, allowing you to go from one unit to the next. All right, let's head over to the blackboard for our example.
It takes 12.5 milliliters of a 0.300 molar HCl solution to neutralize 285 milliliters of NaOH solution. What is the concentration of the NaOH solution? And we're given our balanced equation. Let's start with identifying our given and what we're finding. So we're given 12.5 milliliters of HCl solution. And then we're also given our molarity of our HCl solution as well. Now, whenever you see that molarity, that's gonna be used as your conversion factor. I want you to split that up automatically to moles over liters. So the 0.300 will go with the moles on top, and this will be per every 1 liter of HCl. We're also given 285 milliliters of NaOH solution. All right, now we're finding the concentration of NaOH solution, or really molarity. And once again, molarity is moles over liters. So we first have to find the moles of NaOH, and then we'll divide that by the liters of NaOH. A lot of times students don't know where to start. So my trick for you is whatever you are not looking for, that's what you're gonna start with. So since we're looking for molarity of NaOH, we're gonna start with HCl. So we're gonna start with the milliliters of HCl and then make our way to moles of NaOH. So our first step is to find the moles of NaOH. And let's plan this out. We said we're gonna always start with the compound, or really we're starting with whatever we're not looking for. So since we're finding NaOH, we're gonna start with the milliliters of HCl. Our plan will be starting with the milliliters of HCl, then convert that to liters of HCl using the metric system. From there, we're gonna go from liters of HCl to moles of HCl using the molarity of HCl that was initially given. And then we'll get to moles of HCl. Then we'll use the mole to mole ratio from our balanced equation and get to moles of NaOH. Okay, let's set this up. So starting with our 12.5 milliliters of HCl, let's align the milliliters of HCl so they can cancel. And our first step is to change this to liters of HCl using the metric system. So I'm gonna put a 1 milliliter on the bottom and 10 to the negative third liters on top of HCl. From here, our milliliters of HCl would then cancel and we're at liters of HCl. Next step is to change this to moles of HCl using the molarity that was provided. So I'll put the 0.300 moles on top of HCl, and on the bottom would be 1 liter of HCl. The liters of HCl would then cancel, and we're now at moles of HCl. Now, we wanna find moles of NaOH, so we're gonna use a mole to mole ratio, and we'll take that from our balanced equation. So note that going back to our balanced equation, everything is a 1-to-1 relationship, meaning there is no coefficient in front, there's no number in front of that compound, so it's just a 1 mole relationship to everything. So I'm gonna put 1 mole of NaOH on top and 1 mole of HCl on the bottom. Then once we do that, our moles of HCl would then cancel and we're finally left with moles of NaOH. Make sure to multiply straight across and divide, really in this case it's just divided by 1, and our answer would be 0.00375 moles of NaOH. Our next step is to convert the milliliters to liters of the NaOH that was provided. So in our given, we were given the 285 milliliters of NaOH. So since we're finding molarity, this is gonna be the second part where we have moles that we just found in step 1, and now we're finding the liters of NaOH, and at the end we'll divide. So I'm going to take the milliliters of NaOH and align milliliters and milliliters so they can cancel. And then on top, I'll place 10 to the negative third liters of NaOH. So our milliliters and milliliters cancel, and now we're at liters of NaOH. There's another way to do this. So if you prefer putting 1,000 milliliters on the bottom and a 1 liter on top, that is completely fine. Both of these will give you the same exact answer. So now we have 0.285 liters of NaOH. Our last step is to divide moles of NaOH that we found in step one by the liters of NaOH that we found in step two. Because we're finding molarity, which was the moles of NaOH divided by the liters of NaOH, this is why we first have to start with finding our moles of NaOH, then finding our liters of NaOH, dividing, and that's our final answer. So I'm gonna put the moles of NaOH on top that we found in step one and divide that by the liters of NaOH that we found in step two. Once we do this, this would give us 0.0132 molar solution of NaOH. So by molar solution, I really just mean molarity. That capital M means molarity. You could also put moles over liters as your final answer, but you'll commonly see a capital M.
Why don't you try one out on your own? I've placed a practice problem at the very top of the description box, and at the bottom you'll find the step-by-step solution. Let me know how you do in the comments. And guys, my personal mission is to help millions of students with chemistry. So if I've helped you in any way, let me know by subscribing and liking this video. All right, I wish you the absolute best. I'm gonna go and record the voiceover now.
So I've been working on these molarity notes for a week. I had to make sure to put how to find molarity, different examples of solution stoichiometry. I even covered dilutions. These notes are so much easier to understand than the average textbook. You know, I wish I had something like these notes because when I was in class, there wasn't enough time and I was always rushing to write everything down. So check the link in the description, download the notes, and master molarity. All right, guys, I'll see you in the next video.